It's out wide again with Cancelo. He's got Kevin on the wing. Rodri making a late run. Rodri. Laporte, Rodri!
Yes! Yes!
Yes, yes, and welcome to another video. Hope you're all well. Happy New Year to everybody. What a win City just got there. That was very, very difficult. Hope you enjoyed our celebrations there. And by the way, we're going to do our stream highlights video that's going to come later on tonight. So make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss that when it's released. A massive shout out to today's sponsor, the guys at Manscaped. If you've got hairy ball sack, lads, and you want to get it solved, this is the tool for you. It's the Lawnmower 4.0 with a skin-safe technology to help reduce all those nicks and cuts. It's waterproof. It's got a wireless charging on it, and it's got a torch for that precision manscape. Absolutely mega long battery life as well. If you use our code EXTRA20, that's XCRA20, you get 20% off at checkout and free shipping. Massive shout out to Manscaped. Guys, don't be one of them guys with a hairy ball sack in it. Go chop the bush and use our details. All the stuff is in the description and that. Right, let's get into it then, bro. So what a game this was. I mean, we did our preview, didn't we? And our sort of weekend sort of forward look a few days ago when we said we can go 12 points clear on Liverpool. It's absolutely critical. City coming into this in good form. 10 wins in a row in the Premier League. But Arsenal, the second best form team in the league, this wasn't going to be easy. They've not lost at the Emirates since August. And my God, did they make us work for it.
Arsenal were the better team today. They were really good. Arsenal were absolutely incredible today. I didn't, you know what? It actually took me back how good Arsenal were, and I was just like, it got to a point where I didn't know how we was gonna deal with it because they were passing it around us, they were making space, passing through our lines, they were just making us like basically nothing. Mm. Every time they came forward, they looked dangerous. So I have massive credit to Arsenal today. They shocked me because I always do a thing where I always say we play similar styles of football, but we just play it better because we've got Pep.
Yeah.
But credit to them, they did it well today. They played really well. They had a lot more intensity about the game than City did. We didn't see the usual, like the way we started Leicester, the intensity that we had there, we didn't really have that today. Our passing was pretty sloppy. But, you know what I mean? One red card and can turn a change of events. Obviously, Gabriel gets sent off, and then from that moment onwards, City could smell blood. And then we really turned it on in that second half, really turned it up. Our passing was a lot better. We absolutely smashed it. And then, I mean, Rodri with the goal, at the end, which is incredible. But I am surprised by Arsenal today. And like you say, we said it in the preview, this was going to be difficult. Obviously, this is we said about obviously being 12 points clear. This was a start of that. We needed to get this result out of the way with their home record and that. But you can't write off this Manchester City side.
No, you are right. I mean, the performance wasn't great, yeah, and obviously it's not going to be great. You know, we've got some players out. The bench was weak, and Pep said in his interview after the game that look, we've played three games in a week or something like that. We've played Brentford away. That was a real slog. That was tricky. 2-3 days later, we come into Arsenal, the second best team in the league, currently on form. It was not going to be easy. So you can sort of make the excuse and let them off a little bit for the poor performance because it's not easy. You know what I mean? This time of the year, you're not going to get brilliant performances every single game. What you need and what sometimes you don't get is that desire and that sort of passion from all the players to sort of just keep going for it. That, you know, players like Rodri or Laporte might have picking the ball up in that second half and looking for someone to pass to, and there's no one to pass to because everyone's tired, there's no movement, but you've just got to keep going for it and hope and pray that you get that one chance, and then when you do get that chance, you've got to strike, and that's exactly what we did today. You know, with Rodri coming through at the end, Laporte, you can see the desire. What's Laporte doing in the penalty area in the 92nd minute, you know what I mean?
You know what's funny, actually, in the watch time, I'm pretty sure you said, what's Laporte doing there?
I'm pretty sure I do. I say, like, well, what is Laporte doing up there? You know what he's doing up there? He wants to win. He wants to score the goal. And he gets up there. You know, Rodri makes the run, and it's a good run. Probably one of the first runs we've had, and someone actually making a run in behind the Arsenal defence. Kevin De Bruyne comes through and puts a nice ball over the top. And the rest, as they say, is history. You know, I'm just buzzing with this result. We're now 12 points clear of Liverpool. Obviously, they play tomorrow or today, if you're watching it, the day after the match. And just such a good vibe, you know what I mean? I want to talk about some of these refereeing decisions, bro, because controversy, apparently.
Apparently.
Where should we start? Should we start with the Odegaard potential penalty? Because I think that
was the beginning of it all, wasn't it?
Yeah, so Odegaard comes through. Ederson comes out and makes a sliding challenge, and basically Odegaard goes down, no penalty given. Now, a lot of broadcasters in the UK, Real Ferdinand, Jake Humphries and that, you know, on BT, they're saying it's a penalty. Now, what's your view on this, bro?
It's when you watch it, when you look at it, it's just not a penalty. It's just not. My initial reaction wasn't that it wasn't a penalty anyway, but obviously I thought, when I first watched, I thought Ederson actually got the ball and it was a sick tackle. However, when you watch it back, Ederson doesn't swipe his feet away. Odegaard plants his foot on Ederson's foot. Do you know what I mean? If anything, it's a foul on Ederson because his foot's gone on Ederson's foot. If Odegaard doesn't plant his foot on Ederson's foot, Ederson then gets the ball.
Yeah.
So I don't understand how they were watching it back in slow motion, asking the referee that they have on BT, saying, how is this not a penalty? And I was looking at it going, I don't get it. Ederson hasn't. And they were like, but he's taken his foot. It's like, no, Odegaard's taken Ederson's foot, if anything.
Yeah, I mean, this is the thing, guys. You know, with VAR, sometimes you look into it a little bit too much. And is there a little bit of bias? At the end of the day, what's it brought in there for? It was brought in there to make clear and obvious mistakes and rectify them. In this situation, we've got a situation which is a difficult situation to rule over and accept. Ederson's come to slide challenge, right? He might have got the ball. We'll never know. But Odegaard then stands on Ederson and then goes over. The fact is, whether you're an Arsenal fan or a City fan, is that a clear and obvious penalty? No, it's not. Why is it not? Because Odegaard stands on Ederson's leg or his foot. You know what I mean? So you can't say that, because Ederson's defence would be, if he didn't stand on my foot, I was going to get the ball. Would he have got the ball? We don't know. Why? Because Odegaard stood on the guy's foot, so you'll never know whether he's going to get the ball. The fact is that there's a lot of moaning from the Arsenal players and their fans and pretty much everyone in the media today about some of the decisions. But that one, it's just not a clear and obvious decision. It's not a clear and obvious penalty. The guy stood on his foot, so you can't have that one. What was next, bro? Was it the Bernardo penalty?
Well, we had the Gabriel sending off because he scuffed up the penalty like an idiot.
Right, so you've got the Bernardo penalty, so that is the next one. So Bernardo's got the ball. For me, this is the clearest penalty you've ever seen in your life. You know, and I've still got people on Twitter and again, BT guys, saying it's not a penalty. If you look at it, the guy's leg makes contact with Bernardo Silva's leg. That, for me, is a penalty. To top it off, as Bernardo's sort of going down, the guy grabs his shirt, pulling his shirt.
He makes sure he goes down. He drags him down.
There's two penalties there for me. So, again, I can't accept or understand why anyone is trying to defend that and say it's not a penalty, because it for me, there's two penalties.
It makes sense.
Two penalties.
Double up.
Double up, innit? You know what I mean?
Yeah. We'll have two, please, for that. That doesn't make any sense. And then, was there anything else after that?
Well, then, if you look at the... We need to look at the red card. So then, I mean, what is this guy doing? Gabriel, who, by the way, I was actually saying during the game that Gabriel was playing well. I thought Gabriel was having a good game. We get the penalty. Just accept the L, mate. No, what do you try to do? You try and be a snake. So he goes over to the penalty stop spot and starts scuffing the penalty spot.
Because I didn't see that, but you... It was like it showed us a slight glimpse of it. Have you seen it?
I saw it straight away. You know, the guy's being a snake. It's proper unsportsmanlike. He's trying to scuff the penalty so Mahrez would fall over. Luckily for us, the referee saw it and rightly booked him. That's disgraceful. That is snaky behaviour. Why are you doing that? You know what I mean? Just accept the L.
It doesn't matter if you're vexed about the penalty. If you're pressed about the penalty, it doesn't matter. You don't do that, because then you're going to get yourself booked.
Yeah.
You're not the guy who took Bernardo down or whatever. Do you know what I mean? So chill.
Yeah, so then obviously he gets booked, rightly so. Mahrez dispatches the penalty nicely, and it's 1-1. Suddenly we're back into the game. Then we almost concede. Was it Laporte? Headed the ball over Ederson. Giving me mad Nastasic vibes against Chelsea. Luckily for us, Ake today, who I thought had a bit of a weird game. You know, I don't know if he played well or didn't play well. He seems to get a lot of... I don't know whether just a lot of the Arsenal play came down the right and therefore, you know, every single attack basically come from that side.
The thing is, when that was happening, I did see Ake a lot of the times come into the... like, he was dropping into the box kind of like next to the centre-backs and Sterling was getting back kind of as that left-back kind of thing. I thought Ake had a good game today and I think...
Oh, I don't think he had a bad game. I don't know.
I think, honestly, Ake at the moment is obviously at the... He's in the form of his City career, you could say, do you know what I mean? Because he's not played that much.
No, but he did absolutely magnificently well. He read the situation, he read the danger, got back and made that last-ditch clearance off the line. So we almost conceded straight away from that goal kick that came because Martinelli missed it. Gabriel takes out Gabriel Jesus
because we didn't even see it, did we? Basically, the TV coverage came back, and when it came back, it was a red card, and we're like, "What? What has even happened?" And it was a second yellow, and Gabriel was just in the mud then, and that's where the game changed.
That did change, and you know what? Arsenal fans and the Arsenal manager or whoever, the media can moan about whatever they want, but at the end of the day. They give a penalty away, which was a clear penalty on Bernardo Silva. Gabriel is then a snake and starts scuffing the penalty spot, which he shouldn't do because that's just, if I saw a City player doing that, I wouldn't be happy with that.
No, not at all.
And then he goes and gets himself sent off. Oh, by the way, Martinelli also missed an open net. Like, look, lads, you can have a moan about whatever you want, but ultimately, you played yourself. Right, let's get into the player ratings. These are decided by our Extra Club members. These are the guys at the bottom of the screen. If you want to help support the channel, become an Extra Club member, you can also influence the player ratings. And by the way, if you're watching this before Liverpool play Chelsea, we are doing a Tier 3 live watch-along of that. So if you want to join us, become a Tier 3 member or upgrade your membership to a Tier 3. Right, let's get into it. Edison, 7.9. Cancelo back in the team after his being attacked, you know what I mean? So fair play to him for coming back in so quickly. 7.4. Diaz with a 7.3. Laporte, 6.4. And Ake, 8.8. Gets the man of the defenders brace.
Yeah, he is the man of the defenders, which is mad. When he considered he got Diaz and Laporte in there, but Ake is come out of the top rated one, I thought, like I say. I thought Ake is looking good at the moment, and it's going to be harsh when he gets dropped because of the Walker-Cancelo combination that comes back.
Yep.
And I'll feel bad for him in that because obviously Diaz and Laporte, but you never know, maybe he can edge his way in there. Midfield-wise, Rodri obviously gets the winning goal, gets a 9.8 rating, Extra Club members, man of the match, obviously, because he got that winning goal. And also, it's really, really good to have Rodri back in the side.
Yeah.
He looked a bit leggy today, actually, at times, but honestly, I'm so buzzing to have him back. I'm so buzzing. He's so vital to the way that we play football. De Bruyne with a 7.9 and Bernardo with an 8.
Yeah, no, absolutely. Moving into the attack, Riyad Mahrez, his final game before he goes off to the African Cup of Nations. Best of luck to him. Obviously got us back in the game with his penalty goal. He gets an 8.2. He was the best attacker of the game. Sterling with a 7.7 and Gabby with a 6.8. Subs are on the screen. Pep Guardiola with an 8.7 and the referee with a 6.6. So that concludes the first game of 2022, and what a cracker it was. Manchester City coming out on top with a last-minute goal from Rodri. Hope you've enjoyed the video, guys. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you're new. Go cop yourself a lawnmower 4.0 if you've got a hairy ball sack. Did you know that 85% of partners prefer a man with smooth balls? Yes, it is a fact. Don't be one of those 15%, you know what I mean?
It's not the wave.
It's not the wave. So, all the details will be in the description and the pinned comment, guys. Hope you've all had a happy new year. I'll see you in the next one. See you in a bit.